Another interesting point about the seven deadly sins is that God is supposed to be without sin, even though he brags that he is vain, jealous, and vengeful. So he is admittedly encumbered with half the deadly sins. Well, half the original set, there's more now. Pope Benedict XVI arbitrarily added another seven deadly sins to the original unchanging doctrine. Abortion is considered a mortal sin, of course, but so is genetic engineering. So when Norman Borlaug won his Nobel Prize for engineering triticale and thus allowing another billion or so people to feed themselves, that heroic contribution to humanity was a mortal sin. Other mortal sins include dealing drugs, polluting the environment, and you love this one, causing social injustice. That seems to contradict the church's historic position on anything relating to social justice, doesn't it? The last two of the new set of mortal sins are particularly outrageous when you consider that they came from the Pope, and which Pope it was. The last two of the new and improved list of 14 deadly sins are pedophilia. And being obscenely rich. Now, both of these are supposed to be, they're supposed to result in the death of the immortal soul, I think is the way they're supposed to interpret that, meaning that there's a whole lot of Catholic clergymen who aren't going to heaven. But the new